Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Welcome back to our little project on our 2008 Yamaha R6 motor. Well, listen, we've gotten the block back from Lane Corp, where they were kind enough to punch it out to a 636 kit, which we're going to need because we're actually installing a piston kit from Weisco. Beyond that, we've got a ported head that was done by Star Racing in Americus, Georgia, and a whole bunch of other parts that we're going to need to replace every bearing, seal, and stretch bolt in the whole engine. So if you're ready, we'll get all this put back together. So let's get started. All right, guys, our skill level only goes to 3, but this one's going to be a 3.1. Let's go ahead and go through some of the tools that we're going to need to do this. On your socket side, you want to make sure you've got a range from 8 up to 19, but the one in particular is this 36 millimeter. You can make sure you have one of those. As far as your ratchet, just a standard 3/8, then a 1/4 inch. You want to have a couple of extensions as well. And then you're also going to need just one 10 millimeter box end wrench, a magnet, pick tool, flat blade screwdriver, needle nose pliers. As far as your Allen head side, you need a 5, a 6, an 8, and then a 10. All right, you will need one 30, what they call a Torx bit. Other than that, just a soft blow hammer. Definitely you're going to need a piston ring compression tool, a clutch holder tool, flywheel holder tool, and a decent torque wrench. All right, once you've got all that, want to reference our drawings because this is a lot to get put back together. Now hopefully you bagged and you tagged and you really organized things as you were taking it apart. If you didn't, if you look at our drawings, it'll make more sense when we go to put it back together. As far as the parts you're going to need, well, find us at Partzilla.com and get all of those ordered and assembled and laid out in an organized fashion. And once you've got all of that together, we can get started. All right, let's get started by reinstalling our head studs. Just put a little bit of oil on each one of them before you put them in there. Start them by just going in hand tight to begin with. And then we'll use our extractor slash installer tool to get them put back in to spec. Remember, you've got this one oddball one that goes in that location. You can see the threads at the top, so it'll be pretty obvious where it needs to go in. All right, let's snug them down a little bit. And then what we're gonna do is torque them to around, let's put about 8. That kind of seats them in because there's a lot of actual, if you wanna call it thread area, that's down into the block. So it just needs to be seated in, and that should be more than enough to hold it in place. And if you don't have a set of these, you definitely need to pick them up. It makes life a lot easier as a stud extraction tool set, which also can be used to reinstall them. Just bottom them out and then put just a little bit of torque on them. And then they'll be ready when we actually do install the head. All right, when we sent this off to get it bored and plated, we actually had to remove every single bearing. So we're gonna start putting those back in. Starting with the shift drum. Doing it a little bit old school here. Using just a socket that happens to be the same diameter as our bearing. Get it knocked back in there. All right, next let's go ahead and get in what they call the axle drive bearing. Take a little bit of oil, put it around the case where it's gonna go in. When you're putting this one in, you want the sealed side to go to the outside. So you want to be looking at the bearing, the balls, when you're putting it in. When you're hitting it, it'll make a different sound when it finally bottoms out. It'll kind of be a higher pitch ting, and that's the sound you're looking for. Yeah, she's flush with the edge, and that's where we want it. Let's go ahead and get in the second shift shaft bearing. Just make sure you get it to go in there even. All right, guys, the next part is a little bit tedious. When we sent it off to get this thing bored and plated, they also removed these little nozzles that actually spray up into the piston walls, so we need to get those replaced. And each one of these nozzles has a little O-ring that goes on it, and it goes into this smaller groove. Be careful not to rip this little O-ring. This is pretty fragile, but that's what you want right there. All right, let's get a little bit of oil in each one of these passageways. on the O-rings themselves. Let's go ahead and push them into place. Just use a small punch tool, tap them in very gently, just make sure you've got them lined up perfect when you knock them in. All right, let's start putting our transmission together. First and foremost, we need to go ahead and get these this little oil pipe back in place. And there's one O-ring that goes on the end, and then the other two go up here. All right, a little dab of oil just to help them get in there. And then she just slides right back in here. Little tab goes into that indention right here. That's it. Next, let's go and get the main axle assembly put back in. We can go ahead and put in our screws once we put a little Loctite on them and draw that bearing back down. This is actually a Torx head screw that we're using, and it's a T30. Kind of go from side to side so we can bring her back down evenly. We want to go ahead and restake the end of the bolts. Unfortunately, I didn't put them in exactly the same point, so we've got a place where we can restake it into these little indentions right here. That combined with the red Loctite should hold it together. All right, the shift drum and the shift forks, they pretty much have to go in at the same time. What you want to do is make sure the C is pointing out this direction. Go ahead and start the shaft, and then we want to actually engage it into the gears and then just kind of hold it up in place with a screwdriver. You don't want to insert the end of this yet because we have to put in the shift drum and we want to engage it on that center area. So we've got that held up in place. I'm going to go ahead and wiggle our shift drum in there. All right, now we can use a hook tool to hold up that shift fork and line it up to where its shaft goes through. There you go. Next, go ahead and put in our other shift fork, and it's going to have an R and an L on it. You want the R here and the L next to it, and both of them facing this way. There and there. We're going to go ahead and put the shift rod all the way through it and then put on these cover plates that actually hold these different bearings in place, as well as the shift detent. So, a little bit of Loctite on our bolts. What we're putting in now is what they call the shift drum retainers. And you'll notice on each one, it's got a little where it says actually out. That means it needs to face outward towards you. All right, this first one actually has two purposes. This edge holds this bearing in, and then this part holds that spring down. All right, the second one goes right here and holds the outer edge of this bearing as well as that other shift fork shaft. Let's get our shift shaft back into place. Before we do that, I need to go and put this post back. Now, we can lower this in. So I never took any of this apart, so it's going back the same way it came out. Now, we'll go ahead and put on that outer washer and circlip. But the trick is, you need to be really careful because we actually have the shift forks exposed. So we just don't want to lay the block down on that. We're going to give it a little bit of room on this piece of wood. Now, that'll go there. And we put in our circlip. There, she's in. Now, let's go back. We've got a couple of old baffle plates that need to go back in place. Let's go ahead and do that spring first. Like that. Now let's work on our old baffle plates. There's one. Goes up here. A little bit of Loctite. That's a Torx bit. It's a 30. And the other plate goes right here. Same thing with the Loctite on the other three Torx bolts. All right, all that put back together. It's getting about time to go ahead and get those pistons put in with the connector rods. So what I want to do is move this table out of the way, go ahead and mount this to our engine stand, and then we will continue. So let me get this reshuffled and we'll be right back.